treat me like a coworker, not a piece of crap.
And that was when I saw him. His eyes were a soft, baby blue, kind. I knew we had met in another lifetime, our souls intertwined, a magnetic attraction. We talked for hours about life, love, and loss. What had led him to this moment? But even more so, what had led me here to my own house? He had had a hard life, so different from my own. We were separated, two bodies but the same heart, kept apart by gender, age, socioeconomic status, education, even area codes. I knew I had heard his voice before. In a dream? Another life, maybe?
You got a pretty mouth.
He made me feel like the most beautiful woman in the world. I finally felt seen. His gentle words calmed my turbulent thoughts. And then he said,
"All my life I've moved and I've moved. But when I'm with you, I feel like I'm at home. Can I touch your boob?"
He certainly was a charmer. It was like he was digging for something, searching. He had reached the core of my being. I felt exposed, yet understood. But our time together was cut short.
Please, don't go.
Bye, lady. Thanks for the coffee. I'll always remember you, too. And you.
My head spun with the warm memories of our brief encounter.
Okay, lady. Can you just tell me which one it was?
I'd recognize his eyes from anywhere. That one, I think.
Lady, come on. I listened to your whole dumb story. All he did was steal your Keurig.
No, no. He stole my heart.
No, no, none of that. Okay, so it's that one.